Good morning, everybody. I will start with Pogo because I think it's more difficult to understand because there is a different languages to manage Pogo. It will be a programmer point of view, not a user point of view, because I think you know it as user. A brief history: Pogo is a Java Tango DOS class generator, and it could generate C++, Java, and Python code. It has been started to be written in 2000, 20 years ago, and at the beginning, it has its own code parsing until Pogo 6. From Pogo 7, it will be rewritten using Eclipse plugin, open architectureware, based on Xtext to define the project and the grammar, and Xpand to generate code. Until Pogo 8.1, it used Xtend to generate code. It has been this part has been rewritten. And until Pogo 9.5, it has been ported to Maven and IntelliJ IDE, thanks to Igor. The last distributed release is 9.6.31, using Java 8, compiling and using Java 8. And the last release today is 9.7.2, using Java 11 or above. And thanks to Damien to have ported it. I talk about Xtext. Xtext is an open source it's an open source software framework developing for domain-specific language. And Xtend is a general purpose high-level programming language for Java virtual machine. I have a remark. I worked for C++ and Java code generation, but the Python and Python HL code has been managed by Sebastian from Nexeia. I didn't manage this part. I asked him to do it because I'm not a Python user at all. Okay, the workflow is we have Tango concept is Tango. The Tango designer until today it's me, but I don't know who will in charge now in the future. We have to define a grammar with Xtext and compile it to access the model. We will see later how it works. There is another part to using Xtend to define the templates for Java, for C++, and for Python. And finally, there is another part. This is a GUI to display the model as a tree. The three parts are aggregated in a jar file containing this part and the Eclipse library, the Xtext, and the Xtend library to be used by the programmer user will have the interface to generate XML file And from this XMI file is taken as an input by the workflow to generate the expected code. There is a set directories in the project. So of course, the extend to define the code generated, the class model, and the GUI. There is another directory to on top of the other to generate using Maven, and a special part to define the protected regions, but normally we do not have to modify it. And okay, the other one are used only by the libraries. When you want to start, you can see the wiki written by Igor, and is very useful for a beginner to load it and how to use Maven to generate the jar file. Okay, the project package. Okay, we find again an extend to define the code generated. This one is the xtext one to define the grammar and the GUI. To define the class model inside the Pogo part, you have pogodsl.xtext. And inside this file, we can see what is the meta model defined. We will have a Pogo class defined, as you know, what is a device class in Tango. There is some added features, but it's a description and, of course, class properties, device properties, commands, dynamic commands, attributes, dynamic attributes, forwarded attributes, pipes, states, and some added features. For example, we can see how it works for commands. Commands, it's a list of an object named command. And a command, as you know, is defined by an ID. It's a string. It's on, off, reset, and so on. Input argument, output argument, a description, an inheritance, if the class is inherited. There is an exec method name, which is computed by the software. A display level, bullet period, if expected, if it is dynamic or not, and the excluded states for the state machine. If we want to, you can see, for instance, the display level, it could be operator or expert, and inheritance status is a set of this method. This command could be abstract or not. It could be inherited or not. Could be a concrete, already concrete. Concrete in this class, or something has changed inside the inherited command. When this pogodsl.xtext file has been created, we can compile it, and it creates interface and implementation, and classes to access the different fields of the model. We will see later how to use it. But it's created as at this moment, we create the meta model, we compile and we obtain the different interface and classes. We can see different objects, the argument, the attribute, the command, and so on. Yes, you remember we see the first part. Oh, sorry. We see the first part, the Xtext part, and the compilation to have API on the model. Now we will see the templates with Xtend, how it is defined. When we ask to Pogo to generate, this is the entry point inside this package. We will see Pogo DSL generated docs Xtend, and this is the method which is called at the beginning. It will generate all. It will call all. All parts. We can see there is a directory for CPP, a directory for Java, one for Python, one and one for command for the other ones. For instance, in CPP, we have a CPP device generator class, the method doGenerate with a class is called, okay, this is inside the CPP generator.xtend. And we, in this class, in this, we found this method doGenerate on the object resource. It gets the language, and if the language is a CPP, it will generate the include files, the include file, the source file, the class include file, the class source file, the machine source file, and so on, the class factory and main files, and if it is expected, the make file or the CMake list file. Now, how works the Xtend syntax? Xtend method is defined with the keyword def, the method name, of course, argument, the object Pogo device class, which has been defined in Xtext file. This is the meta model. We need it to generate code, and three simple cuts at the beginning. You put your code, and at the end of this method is the three simple cuts. Everything in this method will be in the code generation. If you put a trace, the trace will be in the code, except the code inside the special double code. For instance, the Xtend calls like if and if for and for loops and for tests, this is the Xtend code itself. Okay, for a model data member, like, okay, this is the Pogo device class, if we want the name. This is simple. Between these double quotes, a special double quotes. The class dot name will be, for instance, a starter. This code will be displayed. Like I said, everything in this method will be displayed. Okay, just include will be displayed, and here it will be replaced by the class name. Extend or Java method call are inside the special double quotes, and the syntax is the first parameter, the method name, and other parameters like the class dot protected area, and for instance, these three parameters. For instance, if we want to display at the beginning a comment like this is a pure text, and okay, CLS name class description, and CLS description description comments. This is, it calls a Java method taking two parameters, the class itself and what kind of comment we need. Okay, for instance, the generate device source file, we have the file header itself, as we see the class description, a comment table, an attribute table. I think you know the code generated, I suppose, and you can see you see what I say with the comment table, the attribute table, okay, the namespace, the protected area to starting the initialization, the constructors, and attributes, pipe, command, and protected, and so on. This method can be written in pure extend. If it's simple, it's easy. We can, like I said before, it's a pure extend code. Or in Java, it returns the text to be displayed in the code. This is an example of extend method, more sophisticated because it used two for loop and if test. Okay, it's like in another language, only this syntax is changing. Just a remark, there's two simple special codes on with Eclipse were obtained by control shift and less, but it's impossible in the LGID to the only way is copy paste. I'm sorry, I didn't find how to do it with IntelliJID. Okay, now the Java GUI part. The Java GUI loads the XML file as a Pogo device class object as defined in the .txt file. Remember the description, the class properties, and so on. And it converts it in a pure Java local class to display it in a tree during the design. And when the generate option is clicked, the device class is retranslated in a Pogo device class, which is the class defined in xtext file. And in the oawutils.java, it is sent to the workflow. It save it as in a XML file and generate the code if it requested. For compatibility reason, a few methods modify the XML file content just before the load and just after the code generation. I think it's historic. I don't know if it's useful. If it's still useful, but it is still present in the Pogo code. I have remarks about protected region, because the protected region are fully managed by the library. Yes, you know how it works. It must be unique. The name must be unique. For instance, starter, reset statistic. It's a key, a unique key to retrieve the code inside the protected region. Now the problem is if we change the class, if we change the command name. If I change my command name reset statistic by stop statistic or so on, yes, the execution method name will change too, and consequently the protected region name change too, but Xtend cannot recognize. And because for Xtend, Xtend gets information from XML file and don't know that the new name correspond to the old name. To avoid this problem, before to create the XML file and to start the workflow, the code and the name, the old name is saved in a list. If to reinject it after the code generation in the new protected region. Okay, thank you, and maybe now we can have questions.
Okay, well, there is no question on the chat yet. I have one. Is there are the tabs, the indentation important in the Xtend language?
Yes, not? Yes. In Xtend language, it's necessary to have the indentation, because the indentation of the Xtend call is in the code. Xtend code, your code will have the same indentation. Yes.
And when you're using this if case or for case, how is it? You need to have like some carriage return between each, or how do you delimit the blocks? You have this if and end if, right?
Yes. Yes. You have the if block and the end if block, and I don't remember, but I think they need to be to have the same indentation.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's why the code, the generated code is using tab, because it's more easy. I think in the future it could be a new feature to have a space indentation, but it's a huge job to. I want to add. I think in the future a good feature to implement is to modernize the code if the kernel group decide to which level of modernizing you want. But until today, it's C++. 98, it's not C++ 11 or C++ 14, but I don't know, because the decision has never been taken to which level you want, we want.
Yeah, we will have to move soon. We will update it.
Yes, we have
it
to move, but how far?
Yeah, this is a decision that we should take at some point. Yeah.
Yes, because depends if everybody have modern compiler or not.
Other okay. Questions?
No questions? It's so clear.
No, maybe can I have another? I'm not sure it's really a question, just more remarks, because you talked about the future.
Yeah.
And so the code base for Pogo is a bit old, and when yes. we look at it using Xtext and Xtend, and because I tried to use it with Java 11, and looking at it I saw that a lot of the technology used in Pogo is getting deprecated, especially Xtext and Xtend. I mean, on the website and the community forum, the first post is about the future of Xtext and Xtend. And there are some people saying that Xtend was used at the time because Java didn't offer some feature that are, but now these features are in Java 11 and the newer versions. So a lot of people are saying that Xtend might die soon. There are the same question about Xtext. Again, for the protected region as well, the developer and the library on his GitHub repository, there is a big warning saying, okay, this is not a good design, you should not use it. And so what should we do about this? Should we start planning about upgrading Pogo to new standard or something? I don't know.
Well, yeah, I think this is something we should should take care of, and
yes,
we should find some alternatives. I don't know if Pascal got some get some idea for about some potential replacement for these technologies.
No, I have no idea of this about this question. Maybe a new technology, I don't know. But for my part, I rewrite Pogo. I've read Pogo three times. the first one with its own parsing, the second one with Xpend, the third one with Xtend, and the fourth one, I don't know. I don't know who and I don't know how. But before the complete rewriting, you will need to continue with this one. I think that's it.
The questions? Okay.
I had a question. Yeah.
Okay.
What do people find is missing from Pogo? I mean, what would they like to have? Yeah? The question to the audience, not to Pascal. Yeah.
A good question.
Frankly, I miss an old feature. In the old days, v6.x, there is a little chance to pay to customize code thanks to template in form of files. Now there is no one way to customize code.
It's very also, there's no way. No, because there is no way, because the code is compiled. Extend is compiled, and it's difficult to. But maybe in the future, with a new technology, it will be possible. I don't know. But for this one, it's complicated. It's very difficult to do it because it's compiled.
Just a question to Pascal. Is it possible to imagine someone writing their own class for the generator which gets used instead of the standard one?
With Xtext? With Xtend?
Yeah.
With Xtend? No, because it's possible, but you have to recompile.
Yeah, you have to recompile, yeah.
Yes, it's compiled inside the jar file.
Mm-hmm.
And it's difficult.
Mm.
Maybe there is a design, but I to make it possible. But yes, but we can think it completely different. But it has not been designed for in this way.
Yeah.
Okay, no other question? If not, Pascal, I think you have more to show for maybe Starter or Astor.
Yes,